get some easy shots. And that's how they've gotten back into this game, along with some good shooting, good clutch shooting. And there again, they got it inside again. Tariq Kirksey's got his first
foul.
Surf continue to work hard for Medina, trying to rally his guys across the way. Their team colors, black, teal, and pink.
Well, you know, Mike, both teams right now just really massive baskets. No team has been able to, the serve hasn't been able to catch up, and it's valid though. And there was Rashawn Young again, getting to the rack. He couldn't finish it, but he got there.
Football numbers up right there. 77 catches, 1,437 yards. You know, his career, he averages close to 19 yards of catches, really among the all-time greatest marks in NFL history.
Junior played for the Lakeland Blue Ducks, and now Randy Moss trying it out here with the Pennsylvania Valley Dogs. What does that mean to the USBL?
Well, I think it's definitely a feather in our cap. Obviously, we think we're the best league outside the NBA for basketball, so he's playing with the second-best talent in the world tonight. And this will show how good he is. And obviously, we sent 136 guys into the NBA. So if you can send 136 guys into the NBA, maybe Randy's thinking it'll be 130
twice. So when you beat that team twice and you have the opposing team coming in with the home spectacle of Randy Moss, maybe Long Island feel like, hey, don't forget about us.
I was talking to Coach Medina before the game, and he said they had a nice little win streak going. The other night they lost to Brooklyn. They only scored 88 points, and he said he was very disappointed in that loss because he said they just didn't come to play. The last time they came here was when we had the game during the day with all the kids were here, and he said he loved that. But I'll tell you what, he said we had a hard time because we played the night before, so we really didn't give our best performance. So he's hoping today that they really will give a better shot.
And Choplin Thunder.
And ladies and gentlemen, the Valley Dogs tonight, number 84, he is a three-time All-American and one of the most premier wide receivers in the NFL today.
Three.
I think one of the things that Coach Dawkins is concerned about is the offensive rebound. You see Coach Medina right there cheering on his surf team, but Coach Dawkins is concerned.
As Reed will check out, Randy Bass will check back in. It's terrific, but he finally misses, and the crowd lets him have it.
Sorry, Johnny.
Not happy with that one. 101-99. Young's been almost perfect tonight. His team trailing 109-108 at the free throw line. 63 seconds is all we have. Medina on the sideline for Long Island, his counterpart shot with Thunder.
This is Derrick Brown, makes his first one.
Well, Coach Barry decided he wanted to get in it, but he said, he just got tossed.
Here we go again.
Hey, there's something down here about the weather.
This is the fourth game here in the Tico Arena,
and two coaches have gone.
Here goes James Ryan. He's a big boy. I tell you what, I wouldn't want to get in an argument with him. But he's gone. I may not know. walking from one end of the floor to the other. You take a look at Rick Barry over here. He's smiling, trying to talk to Franklin Hall and say, wait a minute, what, you know, well, I enjoy coaching against nobody, right? That other one is good.
Now, that's not true. Now, last time that their head coach got tossed, the assistant coach did a heck of a job and got the team back in it.
50-50.
Well, great.
Taken by the Long Island Surf. That's a full timeout. So with the score, the Florida Sea Dragons 57 and the Long Island Surf 36. With 3 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the second quarter, we'll come back to Tico Arena right after this. We just got a note here from some of the officials. The ejected coach is Ron Moore, who is the assistant. Head coach James Ryan is on emergency leave, illness in his family. So running the team now is assistant coach Joe Medina. So you can't blame James Ryan for that one. And the foul as Chutney Gray goes up. He's going to get two shots. The foul to Chutney Gray. His team trailing 63-44 with 30 seconds to go. Chutney makes the first one. 63-45. So we straighten that out about what happened with the coaching staff here with the Long Island Surf. And Chutney Gray gets the second one. Six on the night for Gray, who's averaging 19.3 points per game. Here comes a nice pass up ahead to Chutney Gray. Chutney Gray makes the 2 points on the drive. And the foul goes against Michael Lewis. His first on the night. Oh. And he does. That's nine on the night for Chutney Gray. So it is 63-48. And that one is up no good, but he can't get it. It's halftime. 63-49. The Florida Sea Dragons out ahead of the Long Island Surf here at the Tico Arena. Once it's ready tonight. Take a look at the acting coach over there now, assistant Joe Medina from the Long Island Surf, replacing the other assistant, Ron Moore, who was ejected. And how about that? Called by the Long Island Surf. So, Terry, you look up at 70-57, a 13-point game.
They just threw a technical at Brian Green.
A technical, and Rick is standing there going, what is this? What was this call?
Well, basically what happened was Brian and their coach or assistant coach or whoever is coaching that team down there right now kind of were jawing a little bit with each other, and the official picked it up, and Brian walked away. He, you know, said one more thing, and the official teched him.
You take a look at that. You know what it is? You know, the retaliation the Temple team, and all of a sudden here comes the foul against Chutney Gray. Joe Medina still talking to the officials over there. I tell you, like you said, he's getting his chance to coach. He wants to coach. You take a look at him right there. He wants to coach. He's in charge of the Long Island Surf after the other assistant, Ron Moore, was ejected here in the first half. Brian Green, hey, like you said, he's getting his chance at him right there. He wants to coach. He's in charge of the Long Island Surf after the other assistant, Ron Moore, was ejected here in the first half. Brian Green off the back of the rim, and I tell you what, the Florida Sea Dragons hit a scoring drought here all of a sudden. On the drive is Chutney Gray, and Brian Green on the ball gets it away, but nonetheless going right back up with it is Chutney Gray once again. Give him 13 on the night now.
Well, we're not doing anything offensive.
Andre Howard gets it back out to Howard Brown. That's Chutney Gray with it now. It goes back down in the corner, and Andre Howard hits two. Give him 12 on the night, 72-64. Here we go, Terry, an 8-point. Walking from one end of the floor to the other. You take a look at Rick Barry over here. He's smiling, trying to talk to Franklin Hall and say, wait a minute, what, you know, well, I enjoy coaching against nobody, right? That other one is good.
Now, that's not true. Now, last time their head coach got tossed, the assistant coach did a heck of a job and got the team back in it.
Oh! About to be Demetrius Montgomery. 3, 2, let your moment. And we
basketball.
Escobar's hit by Brian Reese on 22. Players go for the 97. Clay Woodward watching to sail. Time out. West Coast.
I know.
Make it all again. Though you say I could be your answer, I feel lost forever. No matter how it feels today, chances are find a new equation. Chances won't away from me. Chances are I'm gonna hope to be